screen for British boxers. We're down here at Hatton's gym in Hyde. We've got none other than Mark Heffron, who's 16-0 with 13 knockouts. And it's good to see you, Mark. I haven't seen you for a while, man.
Oh, you sold me out, didn't you?
No, nothing like that. Nothing like that. It's good to see you.
Yeah.
Obviously, we're down here to talk a little bit about you, have a little catch-up. Firstly, last time out, you actually went 6 rounds.
Yeah,
you went the distance, which, you know, for you has been something you haven't done for a while.
Yeah.
I mean, what are your thoughts on that fight? A tough guy, that Grafka, wasn't he?
Yeah, got a good 6 rounds in there. Tough lad, yeah, he took some good shots, but my arm went, didn't it? I think I could have let him out there, but I just stepped back and just went through the motions, enjoying myself. And the stuff that me and Ricky have been working on, I was trying it and it was all working in there.
Yeah.
Just enjoying myself, yeah, and good, yeah.
It's interesting, because it did look like you were enjoying yourself. And in a way, you wanted the rounds anyway. When we used to do interviews back in the past, we used to always talk about you wanting rounds.
Yeah.
And you actually got them, so was it good to actually get the rounds under your belt?
Yeah, it was good, yeah. Enjoying myself, yeah. Good, yeah.
Yeah. Now, obviously, you know, you had the hand injury, but your hand injury is cool now, it's healed and everything like that. We're just seeing you there training high intensity, as we know you are. And also, what's it like working on the pads with Ricky and then?
Yeah, it's just a dream come true, isn't it, working with Ricky. Like, it was my idol growing up. I always watched him as a kid growing up and that. And I was passing it all over to me. With him, it's great, enjoying myself. Yeah.
And, you know, obviously, great facility here as well.
Yeah.
So, you know, you're getting the best of not only just the expertise from Ricky, but the facility as well, aren't you?
Yeah, we've got literally everything we need now. There's nothing I don't need. Yeah.
I've noticed a little change in you, you know, since you became a dad.
What?
I've just noticed a bit of a change in you. Like, you're just smiling more and just... But then,
I'm a happy daddy, aren't I, man?
Yeah, she's very cute, Poppy, as well, isn't she? Does that give you extra sort of motivation in the fight game?
Yeah, of course it does, yeah. I come leaving the house every morning, playing with her, and it makes me more hungry, yeah. Can't wait to fight now, 29th of July, yeah.
Yeah, tell us a little bit about that show then. You're headlining, I believe, aren't you?
Yeah, I am fighting. It's supposed to be a British challenge title, but I think it's changed to an international one. They offered the fight to a few British fighters and they're not too bad, right? So it's an international challenge belt now.
I was saying to you earlier, you're sort of knocking on the door for these titles now, aren't you? Now,
yeah.
Of course, you've got Daryl Williams training in this gym, haven't you? The English champion, at 168 pounds. You know, there's a lot of doors and avenues that could open to you, title-wise. I mean, what sort of, if I could say to you, like, white magic wand, and, you know, what would your next year look like? Have you sort of navigated a path yourself in your head?
Not really, no. I'm just taking every fight at a time, innit? Whatever Ricky says, and my manager, Kevin Marie, and Frank Warren, whatever they say, I'll do, innit? Like, just sort of second each fight as they come, though.
Yeah, now, obviously, 16-0, 30 knockouts. You've got a reputation as being a big power puncher.
Yeah.
I mean, do you feel like, in yourself, that you're ready for this step up to title levels?
Yeah, definitely, yeah. I'm ready to step up now. As soon as Ricky says, my manager, Kevin, then I'm ready to go, me, whatever they think.
Yeah.
I'm ready, yeah.
Yeah. You seem in a good place, man.
You seem
in a good place, like, you know, just seeing you, you know, just being around you now, you do seem like you're in a good place.
Yeah, I'm in the best place I've been for years now, yeah.
Yeah. What do you think about fighting in front of your home fans in Oldham? Because that's going to be an interesting one, isn't it?
Yeah, I'm fucking buzzing, yeah. It's like walking distance from my house and... Yeah, I'm buzzing over the moon, yeah, to fight in front of all my own fans and that, like, people are coming to this fight that can't normally make it to my fights and they're all coming now. I've done over 400 tickets and it's absolutely buzzing, yeah.
That's going to be buzzing then, because you bring a few when you're not fighting in Oldham, let's be honest, but when you're actually fighting in Oldham, that's going to be...
The atmosphere's going to be mint, isn't it?
That atmosphere is going to be good. Good. Also, you know, just in terms of other fighters on the card, we caught up with Danny Wright the other day as well. You know, there's quite a few local lads on that card, isn't there?
Yeah, it is, yeah, from Oldham. There's Danny Wright, Chuiko, Jack is called us from that.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's really good, yeah.
Yeah, quality, all right, man. Well, is there anything you just want to say sort of to your fans and friends and whoever?
Thanks to everyone that's coming down and supporting me. The atmosphere's going to be mint, and thanks a lot.
All right, listen, you heard it from Mark Heffron, 16-0, 13 knockouts. How many in the first round? It's 8 in the first round, isn't it?
Yeah.
You know it is. Mark Heffron, Aki Kareem, British boxers, you know the score. Power.